Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss the topic that is interference by parallel sided thin films, and along with that interference we are going to see interference due to reflected light as well as interference due to transmitted light. So these topics related to interference that we are going to see today. So today we are going to see that is interference by parallel sided thin film. So here it is in figure, a thin film is shown and we are talking about interference of light. See, here it is. This is a thin film, that is AB is one surface of the thin film and another surface is CD, and these two surfaces form a very very thin film. Remember, it is a thin, its thickness is very very small compared to light, wavelength of light. Now here this is having refractive index mu and rest of the medium is air medium. So as shown here that a light ray of say wavelength lambda, and it is a monochromatic light, when this ray is incident on the film, so on the surface, first surface that is AB, the part of the light is reflected and we get the reflected ray Q1 R1. So incident ray is P1 Q1 and reflected ray is Q1 R1, and at the same time as the media is changed, the even light is refracted, and here ray Q1 S1 shows the refracted ray. So here in this case we saw a part is reflected, that is a reflected ray Q1 R1, and part is refracted, that is Q1 S1. And now we are considering the thickness of the film, that is D, or we can say even as a thickness T also. So that is thickness of the film. Now how we are getting the interference with the help of this parallel sided film, that we are going to see. See, here it is in this figure, as we saw, that is ray say P1 Q1 when incident, so part is reflected, that we saw, that is Q1 R1, and the part which is refracted, which travels through medium of refractive index mu, so when it reaches to second surface, again the medium is changed, and so at this boundary again the part of this ray is reflected back, okay, and part of the ray is transmitted. So this is transmitted light. So now here it is an incident ray, this is reflected, this is refracted. But due to this refracted ray, we again get a reflected part and transmitted part. And when this ray reaches the boundary of these two medium, so here we get again transmitted ray as well as a reflected ray. So this process is continuous, and due to this we get the different rays to form interference. So now here in this figure, actually how we get interference pattern and dark film and bright film, that we are going to see. See, upon incidenting this ray, the ray Q1 R1 is reflected, and here it is a convex lens or converging lens. So this is one ray which travels the path from this point to this point, and let us say that ray is Q1 R1. Now part of the light is refracted, and again from this surface it is reflected. So due to this reflected ray, again we get the transmitted ray R1, which travels in this direction and reaches to the lens. So similarly, again part of this ray, it is reflected, and some part is transmitted and some part is again reflected back, and part of these ray it is again transmitted and travels in this direction. So in this way the several rays travel in the same direction and they interfere. That means all these rays are traversing different paths, and that is why we get the interference pattern in terms of bright bands, or bright films and dark films. So now we are going to consider the interference due to reflected light. So remember that here when light is incident, here it is reflected back, and we are considering this light is as a reflected light, and we are going to study the interference due to these rays. Similarly, due to this light ray we get these light transmitted rays, so they also interfere, and we are going to see that interference due to transmitted light. So there are two types, that is one interference due to reflected light and interference due to transmitted light. So we are going to see now interference due to reflected light. So here we are going to consider interference due to reflected light. Now see, this is a thin film which we have considered having thickness T, and the material of the film is having refractive index mu. And now how the interference is taking place and how we get bright film and dark film, that we are going to consider. See, here it is, this is a incident ray, that is say from this point we are getting. Now it is partly reflected and partly refracted. So now the incident light is making an angle I with the normal to the surface, first surface, that is this surface, and later on when it is refracted, so we get this is angle of refraction. This is also equivalent. So now after refracted light reaches to this point, again it is reflected back to this point, and this angle is also angle of is equal to angle of refraction, this angle R. So these are also R, and later on it is transmitted and travels in this direction. So now we are going to see how exactly interference is taking place. So now here remember that when light reaches to this point, okay, now the reflected ray starts traveling in this direction, okay, but when we talk about this refracted ray, it travels from B to F. Again, after reflection from this point, it moves from F to D. That means the reflected ray is directly traveling in this direction, and refracted ray is traveling different path, that is B to F to D. So now actually path traveled by refracted ray is B F plus F D. So this is by the time part of ray travels geometrical distance B F F D, this ray has already traveled this much distance, that is B to H. It is air medium, and here it is the glass medium. So now when this reflected ray reaches to this point, remember that refracted ray reaches this point, reflected ray has covered this much distance, that is BH. That is one thing. So that means when this refracted ray travels B to F to D, this reflected ray has covered this BH. But when we talk about path difference, it is important to know that whenever light ray is reflected in air medium, then its phase is changed. That is, also one important factor to consider to understand the path difference between these two rays. So here now we are talking about the optical path difference between the directly reflected ray, that is say BC and DE. So how much path difference? See, this ray is directly traveling in this direction, and we talk about the light is traveling, actually it has covered this much distance. So what is path difference? So remember that here it is clear that we have here it is a distance BH which is covered, and here we see that this ray has covered BF to FD. So remember that BF FD into mu, when we talk about what is path difference, minus, see here I'm going to show you that whenever this ray reaches to point D, this ray has already reached H. So obviously now from this point they are traveling simultaneously, but there it is a path difference, and that path difference delta is equal to mu into BH FD, this mu plus, actually this has traveled the distance, minus BH plus lambda by 2. So we know that whenever the light is reflected in air medium, its phase is changed by, that is a pi change is here. So in case of reflection in glass medium, there is no pi change. So here it is mu BF plus FD minus BH plus lambda by 2. It gives the optical path difference between these two rays. And we know that when we talk about interference, suppose this is one light and this is a ray and this is another. They are reaching at this point simultaneously and both are in phase. We get a bright band, bright spot. But when, suppose let us consider their path is different, that means let us consider here it is this kind of this. So remember this is a path difference. So now remember that this path difference, so now whenever both reaches to this point, as these are out of phase, we get dark spot that we already saw. So that path difference we are going to see in delta is equal to mu BF plus FD minus BH plus lambda by 2 gives the path difference between these. So this is path traveled by reflected ray, and plus there it is a lambda by 2 change is already there. So this is the path traveled by this, and mu times BF plus FD is actually path covered by this. So difference of both gives us the delta, that is optical path difference. Now here it is, remember that mu is refractive index and lambda by 2 is added to BH because of reflection in air medium from glass surface, there it is a phase change. Now from this figure we can say, see here it is triangle BFD. So let us consider this triangle is B, this is F and D. So from this we can say this is angle R, this is also angle R. So we can say that angle BFG is equal to angle GFD, and that is equal to angle R. But here we know that BF is exactly equal to FD. So both are same. And also remember that this is R. So this distance is FG and this is BF. So cos of R is given by FG upon BF. So here we get the value of cos. And we know that BF is equal to FD. But now, therefore we can say BF. Here it is a BF. We already saw BF is equal to FD. But here we get BF. And BF is equal to FG upon cos R. So this is FG upon cos R gives this BF. But we know that F to G is nothing but the thickness of the film T. So by putting that value, we get BF is equal to FG upon cos R is equal to T upon cos R. So that this relation we get in terms of BF. Remember that BF is again equal to BFD. That means even FD is equal to T upon cos R. So now here BF is equal to FD. So hence BF plus FD. So if we see that BA plus FD is equal to 2 times T upon cos R, this is expression say 4.4. Now again from this figure it is clear that CBG is equal to GD, but BD is equal to, this BD is equal to 2 times BG. See, BG is equal to GD, both are same, so we can say GD is equal to again BG. So B to D distance we can consider that is 2 times BG. And now here it is tan R. When we talk about angle R, tan of R is equal to BG upon FG. So see, here it is BG upon FG gives the tan of R. So from this we can say BG is equal to FG times tan R. Now here it is, we have already BD is equal to 2 times BG, and we have got the value BG is equal to FG tan R. So we can put that value BD is equal to 2 BG is equal to 2 FG tan R. And from this we can say BD is equal to 2 T tan R, because of we know that FG is nothing but T. So we have got another equation, that is BD is equal to 2 T tan R. Now let us consider in triangle BHD. See, here it is, this is BHD triangle is there. So here angle HBD, this is angle HBD is equal to 90 minus I. See, here it is HBD, this is that angle, okay, but we know that this angle is 90 degree, and here we know that this is also equal to angle I. So this 90 minus I, so here it is angle HBD is equal to 90 minus I, but we know that angle BHD, see here it is angle BHD is 90, since we have drawn a perpendicular from this point to BC, and so as it is a perpendicular this angle is 90 degree, so angle BHD is 90 degree. So therefore angle BDH, so angle BDH must be I. So we get the value of this angle, that is I. So as angle BDH is equal to I, and second thing, sine I is equal to BH upon BD. So here it is BH and this is BD. So when we talk about angle sine I, that is equal to BH upon BD. So that is equation 4.6. Now we have got the value of sin I. So substituting value of BD from equation 4.5 in equation 4.6. See, here it is, we have already got BD is equal to 2T tan R. So here we have got relation sin I is equal to BH upon BD. So substituting this value, we get BH is equal to, putting the value of BD, BH is equal to 2T tan R into sin I, that is equation 4.7. And according to Snell's law, we know that mu is equal to sin I upon sin R. So therefore sin I is equal to mu times sin R. So we get the value of sin I, just putting that value here, we have BH, that means actually this path, this distance BH is equal to 2T tan R times mu sin R. And so from this we get 2 mu t into sin square r upon cos r. So we already know that is tan is equal to sin, putting the value. So considering tan r, that is sin r upon cos r, just putting the value, we get 2 mu t sin square r upon cos r. So now using equation 4.4 and 4.8 in equation 4.3. So here we have got in 4.8 equation, that is value of BH, okay, and similarly we have got in equation 4.4, that is from this BF plus FD is equal to 2T upon cos R. So now putting the values of BH as well as the value of BA plus FD from equation 4, we get, that is delta. Delta is equal to mu times 2t upon cos r minus 2 mu t sin square r upon cos r. So 2t upon cos r is nothing but bf plus fd, and this is nothing but the value just we saw, that is bh. So now from this relation we can say, taking 2 mu t upon cos r common, we get 1 minus sin square r minus lambda by 2. But we know that 1 minus sin square theta is equal to cos square theta. So using that relation, here we can put 1 minus sin square r is equal to cos square r. So we have 2 mu t upon cos r into cos square r minus lambda by 2. And that is why the path difference delta is 2 mu t cos r minus lambda by 2. So this is what the path difference in case of the interference due to reflected ray. So now this is a path difference, and we can therefore say that if the two rays which are reflected, they reach at the same point or interfere and they travel a different path, then depending on the path difference, there will be a bright point or dark point. So that we are going to see using this path difference, what are the conditions for maxima, that is a bright film, and minima, that is a dark film. See, for maxima, so when we are getting the bright spot, if the path difference, that delta, between two rays arriving is integral multiple of wavelength lambda. So see, suppose this is a ray which has, and another ray is there, so their path difference is integral multiple of, so if zero path difference, they will be in the same phase. Suppose path difference is integral multiple, that is 1 lambda, then again the same wavelength, so their path difference will be multiple, integral multiple of lambda, so that is why again they will meet in a same phase. So for maxima, it is necessary that path difference must be integral multiple of wavelength, that is m lambda. But we know that this delta is, now just we saw, it is 2 mu t cos r minus lambda by 2. And if this delta is exactly equal to m lambda, then we get maxima. So 2 mu t cos r is equal to m lambda, here minus lambda by 2. So, or we can write, that is 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2 m plus lambda into lambda by 2. So from this we get it. So where m is equal to 0, 1, 2, that is an integral multiple. So if this is the case, then here equation 4.11 represents the condition for maxima. That means the two waves are having path difference which is integral multiple of its wavelength, then we are going to get a bright spot or bright film. So that is, this is a condition for maxima. Similarly, we are going to consider the condition for minima. So we know that when two waves arrive at a point which are out of phase, then there it is a dark spot or dark film. So we are going to see condition for minima. So see, it is possible that if the path difference between two rays is an odd multiple of half wavelength, then they produce destructive interference and the film appears dark. So see, here it is, this is a, suppose this is one wave and another wave is of this kind. So there it is a path difference, and when they reach at a point, so as this is positive, this is negative, we know that the effective amplitude will be zero, so intensity, so there must be a path difference of odd multiple of half wavelength. And so therefore we must have, for getting minima, that delta or path difference must be equal to 2m plus 1, that is an odd multiple of half wavelength. Now we know that we already saw this part difference is equal to 2 mu t cos r minus lambda by 2. So that is equal to 2m plus 1 lambda by 2. So from this equation we can say that is 2 mu t cos r, 2 mu t cos r minus lambda by 2 is equal to 2m plus 1 lambda by 2. So from this we get 2 mu t cos r is equal to m lambda plus lambda by 2 plus lambda by 2. Because of this minus lambda by goes here and we get this term. So obviously then we get condition 2 mu t cos r is equal to m plus 1 lambda. So here it is from this. Since phase relationship does not change, if one full wave is added, path difference is maintained. And so therefore 2 mu t cos r can be written as m lambda. Say actually phase relationship, if we consider one m plus 1 m lambda and m lambda, it makes no difference because of a complete one full wave is added. So this is condition for minima, where m is equal to 0, 1, 2 and so on. So this way we got the condition for minima, that is 2 mu t cos r is equal to m lambda, and this is basically condition for minima. Now we are going to consider same interference due to refracted light, refracted or we can say transmitted light. So now here we are not going to consider reflected rays, we are considering transmitted rays. So see, when light is incident here, we are not considering the reflected ray, we are considering the part of ray is refracted. When it reaches here, so some part is reflected back and some part is transmitted. So these are transmitted ray, BR is transmitted ray. Again, when this reflected ray reaches here, again some part is reflected, it reaches here and again part of it is transmitted and part is reflected. So here in this way we get transmitted rays, and when they travel and interfere each other, we get an interference pattern. So now we are going to consider what is optical path difference and what are the conditions for maxima and minima in case of interference due to refracted or transmitted ray. So as we know, this is angle of incidence, so this is angle of refraction. Similarly, these two angles are also equal to angle of refraction, these are also. So here we see that upon reaching light here, it directly travels in this direction, but the reflected part travels B to C and C to D. So see, these are the two points where from this ray is starting and this ray is starting, okay? But now here we observe that the reflected light travels BC plus CD and later on it starts moving from this distance. But when it reaches here, by that time the transmitted ray has already covered this distance. So difference of this path and this path, it gives us actually optical path difference. So now from this, here it is delta is equal to mu, mu is refractive index of the material, and the reflected ray has traveled this distance, that is BC plus CD, so here it is BC plus CD, and minus this BN. Remember that in this case there is no phase change. Say there is no lambda by 2 is used here. So here it is delta is equal to mu times BC plus CD minus BN. So now from figure, again using trigonometric laws, sin I, this is incident ray, I is there. So when we talk about this is incident angle, so same this angle is also equal to I, and this angle is also equal to I, just we saw now. So here it is, so see from figure, here it is sin I is equal to BN upon BD. So this is right angle triangle because we have drawn perpendicular. here it is BN, this is ND and this is BD. So from this, sin I is equal to BN upon BD, and therefore BN is equal to BD times sin I. So again, sin R is equal to BE upon BC. So here it is BE and here it is BC. This is R, sin R is equal to this. So here we have what sin I and value of sin R, and in terms of BN is equal to BD sin I. And from this we can say that is B is equal to BC sin R. But see, AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. See, here it is AB is exactly equal to BC is equal to CD. That is one thing. And BE, see, this is BE is exactly equal to ED. So therefore, we can say BD is equal to BE plus ED, or we can say this BD is equal to 2 times BE. So here we got this BE. So now here it is BD is equal to, as we saw, BE. So BD is equal to 2 times BC sin R. We already saw that here it is 2 BE, but BE is equal to BC sin R. And similarly, therefore BN is equal to, that is 2 times BC sin R into sin I, because if we already saw that BN is equal to, see here it is BD sin I. So just putting the value of BD, and here it is sin I. Now this is equation 4.16, but by Snell's law, again mu is equal to sin I upon sin R. So therefore we have mu times sin R is equal to sin I. So now putting values of sin I in equation 4.16, so here it is, we get that is BN is equal to 2 times BC sin R into value of sin I, that is mu times sin R. So, or we can write BN is equal to 2 mu times BC sin square R, and that is equation 4.17. Now substituting these values of BN in equation 4.15, that is equation for part difference, we get delta is equal to mu times BC plus BD minus 2 mu BC sin square R. So from this we get 2 mu BC into 1 minus sin square R. So again 1 minus sin square R is equal to cos square R. So just putting that value, we get delta is equal to 2 mu BC into cos square R. So see, this is equation mu BC cos square R, and therefore delta is equal to 2 mu BC cos R into cos R. So now here it is cos R is equal to T upon BC. So where T is this thickness, TC is exactly equal to this EC also, and here it is a BC. So when we talk about this R, cos R is equal to T upon BC. So T is equal to BC cos R. So putting this value, we get delta is equal to 2 mu T is equal to BC cos R into this cos R, and we got this equation 4.19. And this is basically an equation for the path difference due to transmitted rays. Now here it is a path difference, and again this path difference is responsible for whether we are getting constructive interference or destructive interference. So now let us consider the conditions for maxima and minima. So as delta is equal to 2 mu t cos R, so for maxima, see, when optical path difference between two transmitted rays is integral multiple of lambda, they produce constructive interference. So obviously this delta must be equal to m times lambda integral multiple of lambda. So here we know delta is equal to 2 mu t cos r, so that is equal to this, and from this we get 2 mu t cos r is equal to m lambda, and this is a condition for maxima where m is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Similarly, for minima, again condition when optical part difference between two rays is an odd multiple of half wavelength, they produce destructive interference and we get finally film appears dark. So obviously delta is equal to, remember that an odd multiple of half wavelength, this is half wavelength and this is odd multiple. So delta is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2m plus 1, plus 1 into lambda by 2. So this is a condition for minima in case of the interference due to transmitted rays. So this way we can get, if this condition is satisfied, it gives condition for minima and we get a dark film or destructive interference. Now by observing the conditions for reflected rays and transmitted rays, note that conditions for brightness and darkness of film for transmitted and reflected rays are exactly opposite to each other. That means the condition which gives bright film in case of reflected ray, the same condition gives dark film or destructive interference in transmitted rays. So this is what the concept of interference using a parallel thin film that we saw, and as well as interference and condition for maxima and minima related to interference due to reflected rays as well as interference due to transmitted rays. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Bye.